Dzień dobry. Hi, my name is Maroua. I'm an architect and urban designer based in Sfax. I'm delighted to have this opportunity to share with you the process of the Projekt PlayGhraiba. For this underprivileged part of Sfax, people cannot afford to entertain themselves. So creating this project could mean creating a small piece of heaven. The project is about making the only existing playground in the community of Ghraiba of over 3,000 inhabitants accessible, attractive, and a playful public space. So after realizing the diagnosis of the area, and of course taking the permission from the local authority, a participatory design workshop was held in the cultural house of Ghraiba to discuss the process of redesigning the town's playground. To this end, the children of the area were invited to attend the workshop and to provide any insight they have on the project. To my delight, many showed up and we managed to cover a wide range of questions instrumental to the development of the project. These could be divided into three sections. First, what is a public space for the Ghraiba's children? Second, the PlayGhraiba project as I and the Ghraiba's children imagine it. And third, how is the participatory model of the project important for them and their town? I would have to say that I was pleasantly surprised by the children's wide participation in the workshop. Still, they did not only show up, but also participated in the discussions with an excitement that was all the more encouraging. From the start, they, each on his and her own way, going from innocent, jovial to ambitious, shared with me their vision of the new playground. And to my surprise, without me bringing the subject up, they raised the budgetary issues that might face them in their dream playground. They actually displayed a precious level of maturity and their regard as they kept modeling their vision of the playground to the technical and economical constraints we discussed. Feasibility of the project was the most important thing they all agreed around. The step after this, of course, is to take and try to translate those sketches and ideas into 2D and 3D drawings. And of course, there, as a designer, you try to reconcile between the desires and vision with norms of security for the safety of the users. Now, as we move forward to the construction, we have tried to be as sustainable as can be by hiring local hardsmith, block, paving, stone installer. It was yet very challenging with the lack of qualified workforce and material scarcity at that remote area. I would like to share with you that this process was not always fairy tale and pink and friendly, flawless. As to reflect on the participatory design initiatives from this experience, I would like to say it's not enough because no matter the numbers of participants, there will be still some kids who couldn't make it. Worse, vandalizing the project. So a deeper work should be done on that area of consciousness, the behavior in public space, the shared public asset and its preservation, in general, citizenship. And a little advice, personal advice, don't get offended when this happens. As you may see, the project is still under construction, it's still in progress. Once it is done, I'm sure I won't miss sharing the outcome of it with you. Thank you.